morning. Please join in singing "We Are Called" number 404, music supplement.
Teaching us. And at this time, I'd ask that all of the parents of children in our school, whether you're eighth grade parents or whatever, I ask that you parents please. There will be two teachers leaving St. Pius School this summer. We want to thank them for their work that they have done with us and letting the Spirit work through them and teaching us all that they know in their minds and in their hearts. We want to give to them a sign of appreciation for their work and dedication to us. And I ask them to please come forward at this time to receive a gift on behalf of our school. Mrs. Jane Banta and Mrs. Jeannie Robards. I will now do a special blessing with Mrs. Banta and Mrs. Robards. They will assist me in this blessing to you for safekeeping this summer, as well as great things coming from you for the coming years too. And it is also a blessing prayer. I'd ask now that you all please stand. God, in your wisdom and in your love, you surround us with the mysteries of the universe. In times long past, you sent us your prophets to teach your laws and to bear witness to your undying love. You sent us your Son to teach us by word and example that true wisdom comes from you alone. Send your Spirit upon these students, their teachers, and their parents. Fill them with your wisdom and your blessings. Grant that during this academic year and summer, they may devote themselves to study and to play and to work and share what they have learned from others with others. May God bless us always, the Father, the Son, their Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go now to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And really let this song sing. We got adults here, so let's sing this last song real loud.
Join in singing number 245, Be Light for Our Eyes.
Thank you.
awards that we're going to give out to our students in grades 3 through 7, and legally following the 8th grade Columbus Community Center for their award ceremony.
Hey.
Brian Tanner. Jake Gardner. Doug Hillsman. Billy Crutcher. Christina Webb. David Chardonnay. Eric Bennett. Scott Wheeler. Susan Strasser. Peter Edrick. Christie Bucellis. Kate Reedy. Stephanie Jericho. Chris Montez. Angie Caldwell. Sierra Ashley. John Nord. Jackie Chee. Sarah Sanders. Jackson Cooper. Cammie Crawford. Evan Hill. Peter Hay. Sean Rafferty. Trish Shepherd. Sean Metzmeyer. Andrew Thompson. Mark Delosier. Lauren Erie.
These were the Booster Club Awards.
Ellen Gidey, Andy Crawford. Come on. These are cheerleading awards for 4 years of being out of cheerleading.
Plenty of awards, so we're going to go through them as quickly as possible so that we can eat lunch for too late. In AP, we're going to start out with Lions Awards for the sixth grade period, and then a year-long Lions Award. For the sixth grade period, Sierra Ashley, Eric Bennett, Jack Cheek, Jay Gardner, Kelly Gidey, Brian Gwynn, Bevan Hill, Doug Hulsman, Peter Isgrid, Kay Reedy, Chris Schwantes, Natalie Sparks, Susan Strasser, DJ Tishy, and Christy Ucellis. And Lions Award for the entire year, all sixth grade periods, have a certificate for these students. Sierra Ashley, Kelly Gidey, Chris Schwantes, Susan Strasser, and DJ Tishy. Lions Award for sixth grade students should come up for a certificate, please. Sixth grade period, Angie Caldwell, Jackson Cooper, Cammy Crawford, Mark Delosier, Lauren Erie, Brian Fetter, Jennifer Hay, Garrett Moore, Sarah Sanders, and David Chardin. And for all sixth grade periods, we have certificates for these students. Angie Caldwell, Cammy Crawford, Brian Fetter, Jennifer Hay, and Sarah Sanders. Chris Schwantes. Jeff Shuffet.
Brian, what was this for?
DJ Tishy.
What was this for?
Stephanie Carrico.
Okay. I thought we're kind of the work.
Congratulations to the mom. We're going to read those to you, and every year we get requests for copies of those. We made some copies, and during lunch, we're going to sell those for $1, a little booklet with all the awards and all of that information. So if you're interested, we'll sell those for $1 later. Okay.
The history of the eighth grade.
sophomore in first grade. They have written this, it's been modified slightly, this is the way they saw their 8 years at St. Pius. In kindergarten, their teachers were Mrs. Maloney and Mrs. Preville. We called our teacher Mrs. Maloney. Our play was called Peter Rabbit. Some of the main characters were Mrs. Rabbit, who was Stephanie Caracol. Peter was Brian Vedder. Roxy was Kenny Crawford. Cottontail was Sierra Ashley. And the sparrow was Ben Hill. Sean, that's why I kissed Warren behind the bookshelf. And I don't know this gentleman, but Aaron Spaulding kissed Ben by the kitchen. In the first grade, their teachers were Mrs. Penn and Mrs. Erie. John Hart came with his broken leg. Kelly, Kate, and Sarah were the three musketeers. Everyone's big brother, sisters were geeks. I don't remember the 8th grade or 7th grade being geeks in the year, but at least they were. Our play was called Stone Soup, and most of the boys were soldiers and the girls were housewives. Grade 2, the teachers were Mrs. Shetland and Mrs. Borger, E.J. Tishy, Jackie Cheek, Susan Strasser, Sean Rafferty came to the class. Susan had short hair, Kenny and Jackie were baptized. Hindi tripped Sean Rafferty and got detention. First communion was held in the gym, but it was supposed to have been the very first thing to ever happen in the new church. DJ left out of class. I don't know how that worked in there. But I guess. Third grade, the teachers were Mrs. Sullivan and Mrs. Sewells. Billy, Chris, and Jeff joined the class. Sean Rafferty and Christian always got the eyes for talking. Kenny had a crush on Mrs. Sewell's daughter. In the fourth grade, the teachers were Mrs. Zier and Mrs. Dietrich, or Miss Dietrich. Susan, Bevan, Angie, and Kenny put rocks in the M&M box and gave it to Sean Rafferty for his birthday. Mrs. Zier gave us a lecture on going together. Brian Glenn came to our class, who gave Mrs. Dietrich a surprise wedding shower with cake, punch, and presents. We were the first class to do the book beat. On our first day of competition, Trish, our captain, was late, and we were in a panic. When we returned after the meet, we all had sad faces of fool. We actually won the round and went to the next level. We had a pizza party in the library to celebrate. In the fifth grade, the teachers were Mrs. Kidd and Mrs. Ford. DJ came back. Gary and Christina also joined our class. Sean Metzmeyer, Mark, and Chris put Brian Fetter on the recycle box, or in the recycle box. Andy broke her collarbone while chasing after Sean Metzmeyer. That's fun, Sean. Chris and Mark were fighting over a pen top and it accidentally hit the chalkboard, bounced off, and hit Mrs. Kidd in the head. The boys' basketball team made it to the city finals, but lost to St. Mark's. Jennifer kicked Lauren during the talent show. We went to Indianapolis for a field trip. Sixth grade teachers were Mrs. Banta and Mrs. Swenson. Andrew and David came, Mark was gone for 2 months, but then he came back. Mrs. Seeler was our teacher for 6 weeks because Mrs. Swenson had a baby. The B group threw markers behind Mrs. Banta's back, and she never knew it. Mrs. D, I guess that's Mrs. Devershire. Killed our pet roach. His name is Fred. Gary had an asthma attack and Mrs. Seeler ran to get Mrs. Bandit. Sarah made Jackson cry. We went to Huntsville. The girls were runner up in the city volleyball. Cheerleading squad won first place at St. Barnabas competition. And the boys won the city championship in baseball and track. seventh grade, the teachers were Mrs. Devershire and Mrs. Whitworth. Kate hit her head on the window. Kenny sprayed Harry with mace. That's really funny. We started our newspaper. Christy and Kelly were always in pen fights with Mrs. Parrish's math lab. We went to Otter Creek and Sean Rapp, we got stuck rock climbing. Bevan and Bonnie tried to help him down, but got pulled up and they were swinging in the air. We drank Kool-Aid at the camp called Bug Juice. We went caving and got drenched. Bevan, Bonnie, and Christina scaled the mountain wall. We tie-dyed shirts and told ghost stories around the campfire. And the raccoon stole a bag of marshmallows. Lauren slipped in the shower and hurt herself. The boys won the city championship in baseball and track. Eighth grade, the teachers were Mrs. Parrish and Mr. Donahoe. Excuse me. Natalie joined our class after the first trimester. We went to Washington, D.C., and Stephanie fell down the Lincoln Memorial steps. The first night in D.C., Angie forgot the room key. Stephanie, Kelly, and Jackie also got locked out. Mike Shannon came to our school. We went to the jail and Sierra was scared by an inmate and jumped a mile high. Jackson came back to our school. Jake broke his hand playing soccer. Bevan and Susan were yelled at by the Mexican guy at the jail. In our play, the boys forgot their lines and we kept saying the same things. The girls had to sing with the boys because nobody could hear the boys. We also broke the fishbowl while we were showing the play to our school. In our play, Sean Metzmeyer was an old man. Mark followed his mother's footsteps as a teacher. Boys won the city title in track and played the toy bowl but lost to Our Lady of Lourdes in the last few minutes. Girls won the league in volleyball and Candy hurt her ankle in basketball.
I'm now going to read you the last will and testament. These are the things the eighth graders leave to the seventh graders. Kenny Butler leaves Andy Meeple the ability to not drop or smash an egg. Lauren Airy leaves the ability to never match to Marcy Stivers and the ability to be confused to Tommy Wilbert. Candy Greenwell leaves her insults to Matt Minton. And Bevan leaves her ability to cut her own bangs to Ashley Cook. Jackson Cooper leaves his ability to grow his hair out and the ability to do well in math to Demi Demery. Jake leaves Brent Smith the ability to take a punch. Trish Shevlin leaves Brandy Barrett the ability to forget things she just read. Sean Metzmar leaves Justin Ford the ability to confuse Mr. Don Hoff. Stephanie Carico leaves her nickname, Shanana, to Kenny Shane. Mark Deloge leaves Gina Rackley the ability to not cheat on people. Brian Fetter leaves his height to Jessica Chisholm. Jennifer Hay leaves her nickname Chuckles to Penny Abel, and she leaves the ability to smile to Kyle Garr. Billy Crutcher leaves his ability in math to Jason Blackburn. Natalie Sparks leaves her height to Scott Durham. And Susan Strasser leaves Jenny Drexler the complexion of her skin. Heather Renfro leaves her nickname Shebang to Susan Clark. Kami Crawford leaves the ability to be loud and have fun to Suzanne Thomas. And Jackie Cheek leaves Jennifer Berry the ability to do math. And to Christy Drone the ability not to get in trouble with teachers.
Kelly E leaves Justin Reed with straight hair. Kate Reed leaves Stephanie Gray the ability not to hear anything. Angie Caldwell leaves Chris Fisher his hair. Brian Featherby's Hickberry, the ability to get A's on Mrs. Debbisher's quizzes. Kenny Buckley's Red Butler, the ability to pull for Duke and not Florida State. Christy Ucella's leaves Amy Reading the ability to play sport. Christina Webb leaves the ability to get off the bus at the right time to John Paul Hamilton. Must be something that I must. Trish Shevlin leaves Kelly Perriman her ability to leave her homework at home and get off in the morning. Sierra Ashley and Jennifer Potts' abilities to see in Algebra 1. DJ Tissue leaves Drew Barnett the ability to laugh. Jason McCool leaves Chris Watson the ability to listen in class. Sarah Sanders leaves Amy Shield the ability to wear big earrings and get away with it. Peter Isbury leaves Amanda Carey for the ability to make Mrs. Devisher mad. Gary Moore leaves Robert Woolridge the ability to catch football. Wilson leaves Kevin McCabe the ability to talk his way out of trouble. And Justin Ford his ability to plow over people in football. Chris Swantees leaves his ability to get in trouble in every class and still not get DIs. And the ability to not get into fights to Todd Garvey. David Chardine leaves the ability to score a touchdown to Kyle Shelton. And Scott Wheeler leaves David Rodenheim the ability to make Mrs. Dwyer mad.
And Eric Bennett leaves his ability to play soccer to Adam Sanders. Tara Schultz leaves her nickname Shabbat to Jessica Renfro. Christina Webb leaves Brent Smith her jokes and her ability to rap, and she leaves Ann Sullivan the ability to yell. Johnny Nord leaves Nick Berry the ability not to get DIs from Mrs. Debbisher. And Sean Redfield leaves his ability to not get in trouble to Jeff Hardesty. Andrew Thompson leaves his ability to keep himself organized to Adam Sparks. And Brian Gwynn leaves Tony Shaffner his ability to get in trouble in library even when he isn't doing anything. Billy Crutcher leaves the whole seventh grade the ability to sing. And Lauren Airy, Jennifer Hay, Natalie Sparks, DJ Tishy, Christy Ucellus leave Stephanie Graves, Penny Abel, Ann Sullivan, Marcy Stuyvesant, Jessica Chisholm the ability to shut up and talk, as DJ says. And Susan Strasser and Bevan Hill leave John Disselkamp the ability to always get in trouble in art. And Jeff Shepard leaves his attendance record to John Paul Hamilton. Okay, we now have, I'm going to read the prophecy of our eighth grade. This is a group of teachers got together and we wrote this. It's all in fun, okay? On June 1st, 1993, graduation was held at St. Pius X. The following fall, the students entered various public and parochial high schools. Although they attended different schools, they remained close friends and made the decision to attend the same college. After searching many catalogs, they decided on King's College in Bermuda, from which they all then graduated in the year 2001. Forced to go their own way to pursue their individual careers, they vowed to reunite 10 years later in 2011. It's a beautiful sunny day in Bermuda. The St. Pius 8th grade class of 1993 reunion is being held on the campus of their former college in Bermuda. Bevan Hill, who is head of the math department at King's College, was head of the reunion committee. Doug Hulsman and Jennifer Hay, who are recently married, were able to take... from their St. Pius Booster Club duties and were able to help them with the planning and organization. John Nord with his waist-length hair and Lauren Airy with her head shave are new age rock stars with the smash hit song, Scrunch Me. They're busy making plans for the entertainment for the reunion. Scott Miller had to arrive early and brought his entire staff of hairdressers to provide the latest in hair coiffures for his former classmates. Kenny Buckler, president of Edible Display Foods Incorporated.
Reading from card designed for all of our cards, furnished the name tag and the place cards for the grand banquet. Kay Greedy, after years of early waking to deliver the morning papers, developed a robotic newspaper delivery system and has made her a millionaire. After discovering the joys of a liberal arts education while in college, David Chardin is the Dean of Arts and Sciences at an Ivy League university. All of the old St. Cloud's football players arrived at the reunion excited and happy. After trying for 20 years to get a rematch with the hated Our Lady of Lourdes 1992 football team, they finally got a rematch. Sean Metzmar, quarterback of the team, and threw six touchdown passes to Christy Yasilis to annihilate words and put the disappointing loss behind them. Mrs. Devishire stopped in on the reunion on her way to scuba dive for a specimen for her research on a middle school science textbook series that she is writing. Mrs. Whitworth has gone into the sports information business with her sister and gets to go off to all the NCAA basketball tournaments. For the 19th straight year, Duke Blue Devils basketball team did not make the Sweet 16. Mrs. Parrish has gotten permission for permanent camp on Dale Otter Lake and didn't hear about the reunion. Mr. Donhoff won a $60 million Powerball lottery payoff and was never heard from again. Strange though, anytime any of the 93 class members needed anything, it seemed like the help always came from somewhere. St. Cloud's principal, Mrs. Super, couldn't attend. She left assistant Principal Sullivan in charge and was in Mexico City for an NCAA convention.
I had the shortest talk. I blessed the food. Congratulations again, and we'll really celebrate tonight too. But congratulations on all your awards that you received. You truly, truly deserve it. Let's ask the Lord to bless the food we're about to eat.
Everybody got back. You got wide angle.
The back row on the count of three, I want you all to get on your tiptoes like that. Ready? One, two, three. I didn't have one of those.
Thank you.
honored to welcome you this night to show honor to our eighth graders who will soon be freshmen in high school. And we acknowledge all of their accomplishments. We have been doing this all day long. We started at liturgy this morning at 10 o'clock, and we reflected upon the Word of God that is being taught to them and acted upon it too. And as we come together this night in these few minutes to recognize them in accomplishment, we ask the Lord to be with us in a special way, acknowledging their friendship to one another and the friendship they have in the Lord Jesus. For this clearly makes us very different than most folk anywhere. As we come, I invite you to please be seated as we now hear a reflection written by
the dead. This class has learned just how important it is in the future, determined to make the most out of every challenge and opportunity that comes our way. As we leave behind friendships, laughter, good times and bad, we take with us the memories to remind us each day we spend here at St. Pius X School. We would like to thank each of the people who instilled in us the spirit that will enable us to live our lives to the fullest. Carpe diem, seize the day.
Listen to our words. We wish to express to you aloud how we feel inside. We thank you for this moment, but all those moments that have led up to this time of recognition and accomplishment. Lord God, continue your blessings upon us who celebrate, for you sent us your Son to teach us how and why. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Listen. Wisdom is calling out. Reason is making herself heard. She stands on the hilltops and at the crossroads. The south gate of the entrance she calls saying, I appeal to you, mankind. I call to everyone on earth. Are you immature? Learn to be mature. Are you foolish? Learn to have sense. Listen to my excellent words. All I'll tell you is right. What I say to you is truth. Lies are hateful to me. I am wisdom, and I am better than fools. Nothing you want can compare with me. I am wisdom, and I have insight. I have knowledge and sound judgment. What you get from me is better than the finest gold, better than the purest silver. I walk the way of righteousness and follow the paths of justice. I give wealth to those who love me and fill their house with treasures.
This coming Sunday, a hero of mine will have been with Jesus for 25 years. And I never met my hero, but I read everything about him, and I read his words. I also have heroes like everybody. because I strive for a goal. My hero is credited with the quote, "Some see things as they are and say why. I dream things that never were and say why not." My hero's name is Bobby Kennedy. I invite everyone else present to please extend your right hand as we bless this group of wonderful people. With hearts filled with gratitude, we thank you, Lord God, for gifting us with good friends. We are especially grateful for all those persons in our lives who have chosen us to be their friends. For truly, this is a rich and sacred trust. By the sacrament of friendship, we share our mutual journeys to you, source of all love and life. In sharing, we find our happiness expanded, our sorrow lightened, and for this blessing, we are indeed grateful. We rejoice in prayer that your Son Jesus has called each of us from the position of servant to the honor of being friend. We are grateful for the numerous opportunities to express that honor in our daily living with each other and in our prayer with Him to you. May this prayer of thanks season all our present friendships as it opens the doors of our hearts to new ones. Blessed are you, God of unity, for entering our lives through friendship. Make us, we pray, worthy of such a gift, by being faithful but not possessive, by being loyal but honest, and by being ever grateful for the gift of good friends. Blessed are you, Lord God, who gives us the joys of friendship. Amen. You may be seated.
DJ Cooper.
Sierra Ashton. Billy Archer. Doug Hillsman. Sean McAfee. Jack McKee. Kelly Keenan. Susan Strasser. Andrew Thompson. Christina Webb. Lauren Geary.
Amen.
Thank you all for coming this evening.
hear how people laugh. As they look at each other, they wonder what each will be. They wonder what each will do, and tomorrow they cannot see. They look back through the memories, they look back through the years. They see a lot of laughter, and recall a silent tear. It's so very hard to say goodbye. It's so hard for them to let go. For each has a separate dream, as they turn down a separate road. They're not only friends, but yet one great big family, trying so hard together to do the best that they can be. As they leave and go on, they watch the time go by, they get through it all, they never say goodbye.
Center to share with them a little party. We thank you for coming.
There you go.
All right, let's go. Party. Thanks.